An orthopedic oncologist is a surgeon that specializes in tumors of bones and muscles, and they can be benign tumors or non-cancerous tumors, or sarcomas, which are a type of cancer. So orthopedic cancers include sarcomas of bone. Those would be things like osteosarcomas or Ewing sarcomas. They can be cancers out in the muscle. And those are called soft tissue sarcomas. Or they can be cancers that spread to bone. And that's called metastatic carcinoma. So if a patient has breast cancer, unfortunately sometimes women with breast cancer get breast cancer that goes to bone, or people with lung cancer or prostate cancer might get metastases that go to bone. And so orthopedic tumors constitute all of those things. A sarcoma is a type of tumor that starts in the bone. So metastatic carcinoma is a cancer that travels to bone, like breast cancer or prostate cancer. A sarcoma is a type of cancer that starts in the bone or starts in the muscle. Sarcomas are actually fairly rare. There are only about 2,500 bone sarcomas diagnosed annually in the United States, and maybe another 10 to 12,000 soft tissue sarcomas diagnosed in the United States. So overall, they constitute probably about 1% of all cancers. So the most common primary bone cancer is something called osteosarcoma. Osteosarcoma is a cancer that arises in the bone, and it typically occurs during the peak growing year, so it tends to happen in teenagers. Unfortunately, why children develop osteosarcoma is unknown. So 90% of the cases are going to arise largely de novo, meaning there's no reason, we don't know why. So it can't be prevented because we really don't know why they occur in the first place. There are other children that have some underlying conditions, such as retinoblastoma, for example, that we know have a high tendency to develop osteosarcoma later in life. So those types of children typically require close surveillance, but most oncologists are doing that for their patients anyway. Bone cancers in general will usually present with pain. Bone sarcomas most commonly occur in children, so children will complain of pain around the knee or pain in the shoulder that doesn't go away, pain that wakes them up from sleep. And when that happens, that probably prompts a referral to a physician to see why that's going on. When patients have metastatic carcinoma to bone that travels to bone, that is usually painful also, which is how it's found. Soft tissue tumors tend not to be painful. So those often can go on for quite a long time before patients will come in and have those treated because they're really not causing any symptoms. They can be detected on physical exam. Often patients will notice a lump themselves in their arm or their leg, or their physician or their family member might see a lump on their body, and that's how they're often detected. But they usually don't say that they hurt. So anytime a patient is diagnosed with cancer, they undergo a staging. And a staging tells the physician and tells the patient what prognosis is and essentially how to direct treatment. And grade refers to how aggressive a cancer appears under the microscope. So cells that are dividing very rapidly have a higher grade, and cells that are dividing very slowly have a lower grade. And a pathologist puts together a constellation of things that they see under the microscope to make that determination. Higher grade cancers have a higher tendency to spread to another part of your body, whereas lower grade cancers tend to stay put where they are. Sarcomas in general are treated with either surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, or a combination of two or three of those things. Some tumors require one of those treatments, other tumors require all three of those treatments. Metastatic carcinoma to bone is often treated with radiation first, if we don't think that someone is at risk of breaking, but if we think that someone's going to break their arm or their leg, then surgery is pretty quickly incorporated into that. So here at Hopkins, we're very team-oriented. We've initiated something called the Sarcoma Multidisciplinary Clinic, where patients can see all the specialists in a single visit. So in the clinic, you can see your orthopedic oncologist, your general surgeon, your radiation oncologist, your chemotherapist, other subspecialties if they're needed, such as plastic surgery or urology. So patients that evaluated in the orthopedic oncology clinic see both the surgeon, our nurses, nurse practitioners, physician assistants. And we very much take a team approach to managing our patients. We take care of all patients with any type of bone or soft tissue tumor, whether it's benign or malignant, and adjust the plan accordingly. Not every patient needs surgery. Some patients just need guidance on how to manage end-of-life affairs. Some patients just need help on trying to navigate what's a very complex system when taking care of their cancer. And then lastly, some patients need surgery, and that's what we will focus on. But we're really there to take care of the whole patient, regardless of how big or small the problem is.